Hi everybody, welcome to another C6CXC Geography Made Simple. I'm your teacher Riley, and it's hope that you will be fully in tune with what I'm about to share today. Today we'll be looking at calculating bearings and direction. Before we go into it, there are some instruments that we need to have. First, we need protractor, we need ruler, we need pencil, and we also need a compass. Okay, before we go any further, let us look at a compass. A compass is an instrument used to calculate the direction between two points. Okay, now we have the main coordinates of a compass, such as the north, south, east, and west, right? And we have the subcoordinate points, such as the northeast, southeast, you know, east, northeast. All of these are subcoordinates. All right, cool. So we have 16 cardinal points on a map in which we're going to be using so as to calculate the exact direction between two points. Okay, so what we're going to be doing is to find those two points. So first, we're talking about the school. We're trying to find the direction from the school at Sofra Estate and the school at Tete Morn Estate. From here to here. Now the very first thing I did was to actually calculate the to mark a line between both. And you will see later on why this line is of great importance. I think that this line needs to be stretched and lengthened. So let me lengthen it a little bit. You use pencil on a map so you can actually erase whatever you actually sketch on a map or draw on a map or any little thing you make on a map so others can actually use the map and understand it. You don't use pen. All right, so you use the pencil. So I have my coordinate points. Now it says from Sofra Estate, school at Sofra Estate. Sorry if I'm butchering the name, but I'm not familiar with this name, right? So the school here, right, to here. Now from it says from, that means you're going to be placing the compass at that area that it says from. So it says from, so I am going to be placing the compass, the middle of the compass here, ensuring that the north is pointing upwards, right, and everything is lined up straight, nice. You can use the grid lines on the map as a means of positioning the compass in a straight position. All right, so it might be a little bit leanish, but it's there. Okay, so remember the line in which I drew earlier on? Okay, this is the line. This is Tete Morn School. I'm trying to find the direction from, and this is at the center of Sofra, school at Sofra Estate, all right? And the line comes all the way here and continues, right? Now, if you look at this, you'll notice that you have two directions. You have east, northeast, and east. Now, in looking at the line, you realize that Tete Morn School is more in line with the east, right? So if I place my pen there, right, it is more like to the east. So I would put Tete Morn School to be east. All right, so from Sofra Estate to Tete Morn School equal east, right? It's an eastern direction. All right, then what I'm going to be doing, I'm going to be calculating the bearings. This is where my protractor comes in. So I'm going to find Tete Morn School, and I'm going to using a line, I'm going to find Sofra Estate School. I place the compass there, ensure everything is lined up properly. Right, you can use, as I said before, you can use a grid reference. Sorry, you can use a grid lines. You can use a grid line so as to ensure that you are measuring up properly. Here the lines come in handy again. So you have this being the line in which I drew earlier on. This is the line in which I drew, right? Okay, cool. This is the line in which I drew. Now let's see where does this line actually cuts through as far as numbering is concerned. Now let's look. I'm trying to keep my compass, my protractor straight. So let's look at the line. And we see there we have 85, and between 85 and 86, you have the line, right? So I would put the degree being it about 86. So the bearings would be 86, right? So it's a direction of east with bearings of 86. All right, now what happened if it was the other way around? How would I calculate the bearings and the direction? Now the first thing, when I say other way around, I mean, let's say that I want it from Tetemorne School to Surfer Estate School, right? First thing I would have to do, draw the line again, all right, between the two points, and get my compass, ensure that the middle of the compass is placed at the exact point, right? Normally I use a protractor, the pointed part, and hold it down on the paper, right? I do that, and it's like that. And when I look at the line again, I realize that it is pointing. Let me shift the map a little bit out of the sun. When I put the compass, normally some persons do the compass a little bit more neater than I do. We can actually have a better play with the map work. I'm trying to get the middle of the compass to sit right comfortable on the exact point, so my finger will hold it down for a bit. All right, so here is the pencil. All right, here is a pencil. Here are 2 points. You have west and west, southwest. Now the school at Suffer, which is right here, I release a little bit, which is right here, right, is in between the 2 points. Right, so I am gonna now have to, in my best of judgment, calculate to see which of these points nearer to here. To me, in my best judgment, it's west. So therefore, it will be direction Tetemorne to Estate. Let's call it SST equal west. Now the bearings would be, you would use a protractor again. Remember, the protractor, this is a half a protractor, right? To get the fullness, you'd have to use half and half. So here, this is 180, right? So this is 180. So I place 180 on a paper, which is here. Right, cool. So this is 180, and I turn the protractor around from the 180 point, ensuring that the protractor is straight, exactly straightened up with the, using the grid line, right? And then I come back to the outer line, and I'm straightening up a little bit still. Right. And when I check it up, it's about probably about 85, 86, similar to what it was before. Yeah, it's about 85, 84. All right, let's play it safe. Let's put, so it was 180 on one side, and it's about probably about 85 on the other. So it is 85, 6 and 6, 16, carry 1, 268. So coming from the Tetemorne School to the S Estate, it will be west direction with a 265 degrees bearing. On the other side, it would be east at a 86 degree bearing. This is how you would calculate bearings and direction using a protractor and using your compass. There are some things that you need to remember. All right, between each point, there's a set amount of degrees between each point. Right? However, in between each point, you're going to have to calculate it. All right, so in between each point is 22.5 degrees. So 22.5 degrees plus 22.5 degrees give you 45 degrees. So this will be 45 degrees. And 22.5 degrees plus 22.5 degrees, this would give you a 90 degree. Right? And you can do this all the way come around. This will be 180. This would be, calculating all around. And then now you would end up with 360 at the top. So north would have 360 depending on where you're starting from. Right? And this would be 200 and... I think it's 270. 270. All right. So thank you for stopping by. Have a wonderful day, guys. Catch you next time. Peace out.